my feet this morning. Amen. Don't you know that's where he belongs?
Amen.
He belongs under your feet. The Bible says that we are the head and not the tail.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
We are the lender and not the borrower.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Listen, I'd like to welcome everyone out this morning to our play. It's entitled, Have You Heard? A Christmas Play. We have been practicing for a couple of months now, trying to get our lines down and trying to make sure that the play goes smoothly. And I'm going to tell you, most of my cast are a nervous wreck. A lot of them have never acted before, and so they are moving out of their comfort zone to be able to present to you this play this morning. Amen. And I want to thank God for that, because,
yes,
you know, that's faith. They're trusting God for something that they've never done before, but they're going to step out and do it.
Yes.
That's faith.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
I also want to, before we even get started, I want to give our sister Itzy a shout out this morning. Stand up, Itzy. Give her a shout out. Amen. She helped with the props. She did all this here that you see up here. That was Itzy. So we really appreciate you, sister. Amen.
Amen.
Put that work in, man. And so this morning, I would like for you to just sit back. I'd like for you to open up your hearts, open up your minds, open up your spirits, and allow God to speak to you this morning. Because I believe that this play is going to minister to you, to your heart this morning. It may minister to a situation that you're in this morning. It may minister to a memory that you may have that is tormenting you. And I believe God's going to help you this morning. So this morning I present to you our play, Have You Heard?
Wants to like control us on giving stuff to people. It's a conspiracy.
Wait, does that mean you forgot to buy my presents this year?
Have you heard about the real rock? the rock of salvation. His name is Jesus. He can heal you. See, those rocks, they're not going to do anything for you. See, you're talking about giving your mind to things and yeah. opening up your heart. That's what Jesus wants.
Yeah, you know, I think our bus is here.
Your bus?
Yeah. Are you sure
you want? I don't want a Christian. But ma'am, would you like the living rock? The rock of your salvation, ma'am. Jesus. My goodness. I mean, people believe that rocks can heal you. Really? I mean, what are we coming to? They got crystals that they believe that if they only open up their mind and their heart, that they can heal them. When we have the rock of salvation to lean upon, that can truly heal.
Cristo que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga, no, Señor, haga su voluntad como la tierra y el cielo, denos nuestro pan de cada día.
Oh, hola.
Church is the mother of all churches. It doesn't matter the religion. Did you know that?
Hold on. Let me wrap my head around it. So you're saying that the Catholic Church is the mother of all churches?
Yes.
Does all these other churches know that? The Baptists don't know. The Episcopals don't know. I mean, who's going to tell them that?
Well, just pray to the beast and you'll find out.
Pray to the beast. Wow.
And did you know that he's the substitute here in earth for Jesus Christ? Did you know that?
First of all, ma'am, hold on.
No.
Ma'am? Wow.
We need to pray. Oh, by
the way. Yeah, we need to pray for you, ma'am, because Jesus doesn't need a substitute.
I have his picture right here.
That's not Jesus.
Well, I don't know.
I don't know who that is, but that's not Jesus.
I have one for you right
now. No. You can keep that, man. Listen, ma'am. Somebody sold you a bill of goods because Jesus doesn't need a substitute. He's God all by himself.
You just pray with me and you'll find out. You'll see.
No, I think if I pray with you, something might happen to me, but I'm not going to do that. But ma'am, listen, on a serious note,
you know what?
Jesus Christ,
you know what?
Is the Father of all creation, mm-hmm. and he is the Lord of all the churches. Okay. And only through him can man find true religion.
You know what? I gotta go now. Did you hear that? That's for me.
That's for you.
Yes, because that's my Uber.
That's your Uber. But ma'am, Jesus wants to set you free from religion, ma'am.
Thank you. Next time.
Next time. Wow. I mean, we get so caught up in so many things. People are caught up in religion and believe that the Pope or a crucifix can save you, when the only thing can save you and set you free is the Son of the living God. God doesn't need a substitute. He's God all by himself. He can do anything that you need him to do because he has all power and authority in his hands.
Down with Trump.
Young lady, what are you protesting?
Gosh, have you heard?
Heard what?
Trump's latest plan.
Now what is Trump up to?
What did he not do?
That's the truth.
So let me tell you, he claims that we need a outer space army to watch our satellites. Can you believe that?
What?
Yes. Well, you know what is crazier?
What?
Who's going to pay for that?
Well, listen, whatever the case, whatever Trump is doing, I don't know who's going to pay for that, but I know the money
can
go.
Well, I know who's going to pay for it.
I know where the money could go.
Well, let me tell you. Do you want to know how much that little satellite spacing is going to cost us?
How much is it going to cost us?
$13 billion.
$13 billion?
Do you know what we can do with that money?
Yes.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, there are kids that are starving. There are people that are homeless that could use that money.
So happy somebody can relate to what I'm thinking.
Yeah, so they're going to put that money in the stars. So when we start Star Wars now or something?
Well, don't be wrong. Maybe one day we have those cars out of space.
I doubt that very soon.
Can you imagine we driving one of those up there and maybe we have the army over there?
No, we can do without that army. But ma'am, I understand that you're upset with Trump about, you know, frivolously spending our money. But have you ever thought about praying for our leader?
Well, can you pray for our president?
Well, he is our president.
Well, can
have you thought about praying for him?
Well, I thought about it, but the more I think about it, the more I can think of, like, what he's doing. So, well, let me tell you something. You can pray for me, and I can mind change, but after I see the president. Yeah.
Well, listen, ma'am.
What you saying?
Regardless of if President Trump changes or not, you need to pray for him so that God can change your heart. You see, because you're out here protesting, and I'm not against your protest.
But you agree with
me? I didn't say I agree with you.
Well, you
but
understand.
I'm not against your protest because it's your choice to do that. Okay? But in order for there to be change must first start within you. And so, I
so
don't know
do
that
think,
can change you.
Do you think if I change, Trump is going to look at me and change? No, that's what I'm saying. We can pray for Trump all we want, but that he's going to change, I don't know.
Well, ma'am, this is not about Trump, this is about you. And what I'm trying to tell you now, and just give me a moment of your time, is that change starts within you and I. And I know the man that can change you. Have you heard about Jesus? He can change you. The Bible says that if you open up your heart, he will come in and sit with you or sup with you and you with him. He said that if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord.
Lord, I'm praying right now that you will sit with Trump and have his changing ways.
Oh, so you mocking me?
No. I'm praying for Trump.
Oh, you're praying for Trump?
Yeah.
Well, listen, I want to pray with you. Will you pray with me? Will you take my hand and pray
okay.
with me?
Okay. I have to meet my other leaders over there. They know I'm doing the protest. Can you imagine me?
But can't they wait a minute?
Can you guys wait? Oh, no. Look at them. Ooh, they're just, they go at it right now. Down with Trump.
Ma'am.
Next time, I promise I pray.
Ma'am.
And hopefully Trump will change.
Jesus will change.
Down with Trump. Down with
Wow. isn't that so ironic that everybody believes in everything else but God. And when you present him to them, they have everything else to do instead of taking just a moment of their time and allowing Jesus into their hearts to change them. You see, we all want change, don't we? But what we have to understand is that change starts with us. We can look at people from a distance, from an outside view, and we can judge them according to what we see them doing. But we miss looking at ourselves in the mirror. See, it's not about the other person. It's about us. So what do you, what kind of treatments are they giving you for the cancer?
They gave me all kinds of treatment. I lost all my hair. Wow. I'm not feeling very well.
Wow. Well, ma'am, I feel really, really bad for you. I really do, ma'am. You know, both of my parents died from cancer. And I seen them suffer. And it was an agonizing suffering, agonizing death. So I can empathize with what you're going through. But ma'am, listen. Have you heard about the healer?
Yeah, he's in Mexico. I'm going to go for the miracle drug that they have.
The miracle drug in Mexico?
Yes.
Have you... You really believe that?
Yes.
Have you given those people your money already?
Yes.
Oh, man.
They're gonna help me.
Oh, you're so...
Stars goes to them. Lots of people goes to them. And they got healed.
They got healed?
Yes.
Ma'am, listen, I know a healer that can heal you, that can take that cancer away. Matter of fact, I've seen with my own eyes, I've seen him raise people from the dead. I've seen him cause limbs to grow out. I've seen him cause cancers to be ceased and desist. Would you like for him to heal you?
Now. I need him now.
He's here right now for you, if you allow me to pray with you. His name is Jesus. Have you heard about him?
Jesus.
Yes, Jesus. He wants to heal you from your cancer. You don't have to be stuck with that disease now. God can heal you.
So can this miracle drug.
Well, will you pray with me before you go? Let's pray. Will you pray with me? Father, right now, heal her. Right now, God, touch her. Was that a car horn?
Oh, that's my ride.
Well, ma'am, let's finish praying.
I gotta go to Mexico. Bye. Nice to meet you.
God really wants to heal you. She's sick, dying from cancer. God wants to heal her. The Bible says that God is the balm of Gilead. He is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that healeth thee. Yet people turn away from him. They'd rather trust the doctors who are just practicing. That's why they're called practitioners, because they're practicing, instead of the great physician who's never lost a patient. Matter of fact, I have heard about K2. I seen a feed on my Facebook page about K2. There was this young man in New York City, and he was flailing on the ground on the cement, and he had lost complete control of his mental and physical faculties. He had no control of himself. Is that what happened to your son?
Well, they just told me he's in a coma, and you know, this morning I didn't see him that good. He was very depressed. I know I should have just stayed at home.
Oh, wait, stop, ma'am. First of all, don't blame yourself. Don't do that to yourself. Because that will torment you forever. And you know, I mean, your son made a decision. And he made the decision that he thought was good for him. But let me ask you a personal question. Was he trying to commit suicide?
Well, I don't know. The doctors just tell me this. He's in coma. We're doing some tests. Mm-hmm. So we just have to wait and see.
Wow. Well, you know, I feel really sorry for you.
talking about God?
Yeah, I'm talking about his son, Jesus.
Well, you know what? I'm sorry, but I don't believe in God or Jesus.
What?
I don't believe. If there is a God, why would my son be in this situation?
Well, ma'am, I'm really glad that you asked that question. But first of all, even though you don't believe in God, God believes in you. Secondly, your son made that decision not because God made him make that decision, but because he has a free will. And we all have a free will. And so out of his free will, he made a decision to try this drug. And that's why he's in the position that he's in this morning, in a coma. But see, the grace of God is so great that even though he made a bad decision, God can turn it for his good.
I don't think anybody can help him. The only person that can help him is the doctor at the hospital.
Well, ma'am, listen, the doctors at the hospital needs God's help, too. And so I want to take you directly to the maker of your son, to the one that can raise your son up off of that bed, out of that
You know what? It's the hospital calling me again. I'm sorry.
But, ma'am.
I'm sorry. Really?
But, ma'am.
Sorry.
Your son is in a dire situation. If we just pray for him, God can. Ma'am. How many times have we been in a place where our loved ones have been in situations where it seemed hopeless, where it seemed like no one could help them, and then we put our trust in man because man gave us lofty words and they begin to tell us about what they thought was right and what they thought might be happening when all we had to do was go to the maker of our souls, when all we had to do was go to the one that created us. See, the Bible says God formed us and shaped us while we were yet in our mother's womb. He knows every inch of us. He knows everything about us. And as we are on our deathbeds, God says, I can raise you up off of your deathbed. He did it for Lazarus. And if he can do it for Lazarus, he can do it for you.
Those shoes are so cute. Did you see mine? I got some new ones too. Look at them. Check it out. Oh, I know. You know what? I still haven't got anything from my zodiac.
Oh,
I'm so sorry. I didn't see you. I was looking at my zodiac app.
The zodiac app?
Yeah.
What's the zodiac app and why are you looking at it?
Oh my goodness. He doesn't know. So, what it is. Your sign, your zodiac sign. So once you put it in, it kind of gives you like guidance, you know, what's good for today, tomorrow, 2 months from now, a year.
Wow, that sounds kind of like witchcraft.
No.
Is it palm reading or do they have a crystal ball? What are the people doing to know that stuff?
He's so behind times here.
Bro, it's the coolest thing ever. Based on your month, you become an animal. Like me, Grandma, we're both scorpions.
Scorpions?
Yeah.
So, do you guys have tails?
No. Oh my gosh.
So
this is really.
So how do you become a scorpion? Really? What is that?
Well, we can show you. What's your month?
Nah, that's okay.
No, come on. It's cool. Everyone has it.
I don't.
Yeah. What month were you born in?
That's confidential information. So let me ask you this question. So this, you're saying that this zodiac app tells you everything about you. It tells you about your future, what type of day you're going to be having, and things of that nature.
It gives you guidance. Everybody needs guidance.
Okay. So is this connected to the stars?
Horoscope.
It's your horoscope.
Yeah.
So, who was the creator of the horoscope?
The app developer. Oh my gosh. You're
okay.
So behind.
So
it's all about the apps.
It's all about the app. So the man that created the app knows you. That's what you're telling me. You're telling me that the man that created the app knows you. He knows all about you. He knows how to direct your life. Is that what you're telling me?
We gave him our month.
You gave him your month.
Yeah.
And he deduced from your month everything that's going to happen in your life.
Oh, I think he's shopping. Bye.
Wow.
Can't wait to get these new Gucci sandals on my feet.
Gucci sandals? Wow. You've been through up to this point, God already knew about it. And everything that you will go through from this point moving forward, God has already mapped it out. The question is, will you partner with Him so that it can be walked out in His will? That's the question. Zodiac, yeah. Really? Wow. Struggling and we're going through some things, you know, you have your brother and your sister there to lift you up and to help you.
I told you, I go to church.
But see, the Bible also tells us that the ways of a man always seems right to him, but the end thereof is destruction. Have you read that? Did you know that, ma'am?
I go to church, sir. I'm not gonna tell you that.
Okay. So because you go to church, that makes you good?
I was baptized as a baby.
So you were baptized as a baby. Did you know what was happening to you as a baby?
Doesn't he know that we all God's children? He don't know this? That's why he needs to go to church.
Well, the Bible says that we become God's children when we give our lives to Him. The Bible says that just because we go to church don't make us right with God. You can be religious and not be right with God. You can go to church every day of the week and still be not right with God. But the Bible says that if you open up your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, then you shall be saved and forgiven of your sins.
Oh, he's willing to be saved. Stop it, old girl.
But ma'am.
Always talking about sins.
Ma'am. We're all sinners. We all fall short of the glory of God. There are none righteous. No, not one. You know, the Bible tells you and I that we need to be careful when we're entertaining strangers. Because we might be entertaining an angel unbeknownst to ourselves. Hello. My name is Gabriel, the archangel. And I'm here to tell you this morning about the Son of God. The Son that left heaven, lived on this earth for 33 years, was hung on a cross and died, and rose from the dead so that you and I could have eternal life. Oh, I'm not talking about your Easter Sunday Jesus. I'm not talking about heal your body. I'm talking about the Jesus this morning that can put together your relationship and mend your home. That's the Jesus I'm talking about. I'm talking about the Jesus this morning that can open up doors that no man can shut and no devil in hell could oppose. That's the Jesus I'm talking about this morning. You see, he loved you so much that he left the right hand of the Father and came down to earth. The Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That's the Jesus that I'm talking about this morning. And if you're in this place this morning, you can never say you haven't heard. Because Jesus is in the house. Let's bow our heads. Hallelujah. So we put on this little skit, this play, Have You Heard? Because we wanted to minister to our Lord. And I want you to know this morning that if you've never heard the gospel truth, well, I want to tell you the gospel truth this morning, and that is that Jesus loves you. He really do. He loves you so much that he sacrificed himself for you. And he says that if you would only believe, the Bible says if you only believe, you shall be saved. He says if you have the faith as a grain of mustard seed, a small, tiny seed. He's not asking for much faith. He said just a little drop. He don't need this whole ocean of faith. All he needs is a little bitty drop of faith. He says, I'll make you whole. He says, if you have that much faith, I'll heal you. He says, if you have that much faith, I'll save you. I'll set you free. He says, all I need is a little. You see, what happens in the world is that we have gotten to a place where people have convinced us that we have to be so right to love God. We have to get our house in order. We have to be so good. I'm here to tell you that that will never happen. You'll never be good enough to please God. You'll never be right enough to come into his presence and say, okay, now I'm worthy. Because none of us will never be worthy enough. But he said, if you got just a little bit of faith, I'll take that. He says, because if you can give me a little bit, I can give you a lot. And this morning, maybe you're in this place, and you've seen the play. Maybe one of the scenes ministered to your life. Maybe you're religious. Maybe you have a loved one that is going through trials and tribulations in their lives with drugs and things of that nature, and you're frustrated and you're tired, and you say, well, if God was such a real God, then why are these things happening? Well, I'm going to tell you this morning, they're happening because God made us free will agents. God says that you have a will, you can do what you want, but there's consequences to your actions. So God didn't do it. We often do it to ourselves. Or maybe you're in this place this morning, amen, and you are protesting things in your spirit. Or you haven't said them out loud, but in your spirit you're protesting things, and they have got you all twisted up on the inside. Because you refuse to forgive. Because you refuse to let go of things. Because you refuse to say, I'm sorry. You're all twisted up on the inside. This morning, God wants to set you free. Jesus says, I've come that those that are bound may be set free. And if you're in this place this morning, and the Spirit of God has spoken to your heart, and you say, Pastor Dave, as you close this morning, pray for me. I need Jesus. Lift your hand real quick and put it right back down. Just say, Pastor Dave, I need Jesus. Put your hand right back up, right back down. No one's looking around. Amen. In respect to your neighbor. Real quick, right back up, right back down. Amen. Maybe God has drew you into this place, or you're invited by your loved one or by your neighbor. You're invited. I want you to know that this morning is your appointed time. It's not by coincidence that you're here. And I know you say, well, I made the decision to be here, but God drew you. Hear me. God drew you. And the Bible says that today is the day of salvation. Choose you this day whom you will serve. our salvation. See, we're celebrating our salvation in Jesus. Christmas means Christ Mass, means a celebration of Jesus. And being in that season, there's a posture of our heart that we must take in order to truly worship God. And that posture is surrender. And so this morning, as you're sitting there, under the sound of my voice, if you would like, just pray this prayer with me this morning. Just repeat after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I love you and I appreciate you. I thank you for your sacrifice on Calvary's tree. I thank you for loving me enough that you didn't consider yourself, but died on a tree. Lord, give me newness of life. Give me eternal salvation in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Lord, for this time of salvation and renewal in spirit. I give you all the glory and all the honor. From this day forward, I will live and be an example of you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's stand to our feet this morning. Amen. You got a Christmas song? Well, listen, guys.